from truck one, tow truck one on scene. We got a one half story window frame fire showing from the front door.
Hello, my name is Roman Sawicki. I am a firefighter for Mountainside Fire Department. And in honor of the Fire Prevention Week for 2020, we're here to give you some fire safety tips. The first tip I have for you is smoke detectors in your home. Make sure every home has a smoke detector and you check and maintain them regularly and change the batteries at least twice a year. A good time to do that would be when you change your clocks in the spring and in the fall. You should also have CO detectors in your home as well, because CO gas is odorless and tasteless, and only the CO detectors will be able to detect the CO in your house, which could come from your furnace or your water heater or other sources. Modern smoke detectors are also CO detectors all in one, and it should also be checked and inspected on a regular basis. Should you have a fire in your home or have any kind of an emergency, simply dial 911 and give your address and what's the reason for the call, and rest assured help will be on its way. If there is a fire in your home, you want to exit the home as quickly as possible, and with your parents you want to come up with what's called exit drills in the home, or EDITH is the acronym. So every room in your home should have two ways out, or you should have two ways out of your home to be exact, and your parents will review all that with you. When you're leaving your house and there's smoke in the house, stay low to the floor because smoke rises and you'll be able to see better down below, and exit the house as instructed by your parents. Again, each room should have two ways out of the house, whether it's the front door, the back door, the garage, or a big open window. Once you exit the house, you are to meet at your pre-planned place that your parents tell you about. It could be an oak tree in the front, as in this property, it could be a mailbox, or it could be some other big place that everybody is familiar with, because that's where you could do your family headcount. If you come outside and you realize your pet dog or cat is still inside, please don't go back inside once you're outside. Your animals will find their way out. They know how to do that. If you happen to be on fire, and your sleeve or something, part of your body, catches on fire, what you want to do is do a stop, drop, and roll. Stop where you are, drop to the floor, cover your face, and roll back and forth along the ground until the fire is put out. The theme for this year's Fire Prevention Week is fire safety in the kitchen. And we are in the kitchen here, and I want to offer you some kitchen safety tips. Kitchen fires are the number one cause for house fires and injuries, and in the kitchen, unattended cooking or stove fires are the number one cause for starting a kitchen fire. When you're cooking something, make sure you're watching and staying in the kitchen. It's very easy to run out to check on the kids or to change a load of laundry and come back. Stay in the kitchen while you have the burners going. You can also keep a couple of lids on the stove that are bigger than the pot you're cooking in, so in case something does overboil, you can quickly cover the pot with the appropriate lid. And should a fire start in the kitchen, please do not throw water on the fire, because that's only going to make it worse and the water could scald you, causing a different problem. Should you have a fire in your kitchen, please leave the kitchen as soon as possible, leave your home, make sure you account for all your family members, and dial 911. The police department and the fire department will respond to your home and we will take care of the fire. Should you wish to contact the fire department any other time, if you'd like to visit the fire department or you have any other questions regarding your smoke detectors or anything like that, we'll be more than happy to discuss things with you, even come to your house at any time. So feel free to call the fire department and just make sure you let us know it's not an emergency. We'll be more than happy to come out and see you.